Hey, how you doing? Today's video, I want to talk about carnality and how it leads to fake spirituality. Now, if we look in the Bible, 1 Corinthians 3, verse 1, he says, I, brethren, could not speak to you as spiritual people, but as to carnal, as to babes in Christ. So you have the spiritual and you have the carnal. Now, if we go over to Romans 8, we'll see here, and I'm just going to talk, go through a few things and just talk about what spirituality is, show you what spirituality is. Romans 8, verse 6, he says, "For to be carnally minded is death, but to be spiritually minded is life and peace." So, right there, to be spiritual. And to have a spiritual mind, that's life and peace. And if you're carnal, it's death. It leads to death. Romans 15:27. Flip over there if you can. It pleased them indeed, and they are their debtors. For if the Gentiles have been partakers of their spiritual things, their duty is also to minister to them in material things. So those who are spiritual are going to share the material things that they have, and they're going to give things that are material, because they become spiritual, and God has blessed them. So they're going to share material things. So that's a trait. That's a characteristic of somebody who is spiritual. Go over to 1 Corinthians 14:37. That's what I'm going to do here. I'm going to show you a few things of what it means to be spiritual, and then we'll go through and I'll show you some of the carnal things and what we're talking about when we're talking about carnality. So 1 Corinthians 14:37, if anyone thinks himself to be a prophet or spiritual, let him acknowledge that the things which I write to you are the commandments of the Lord. But if anyone is ignorant, let him be ignorant. So anyone who's spiritual, they're going to read the book of 1 Corinthians here by Paul, who was a Jew, and they're going to say, who was a Jew and became a Christian after he saw Jesus Christ and was blinded by a light, and Jesus met him on the road to Damascus and then began to give him the gospel of Jesus Christ and reveal to him the things that he had showed Jesus Christ to, and he gave to him the gospel to go out into all the world and to give people the good news of Jesus Christ. So Paul, anybody who's spiritual, they're going to read 1 Corinthians, and they're going to read the things that Paul has written, and they're going to say, yes, this man is spiritual. The things that are written here are from God. And the people that don't agree with this, those are people that are carnal. Those are people who are into carnality. And they're ignorant, because that's what he says. If anyone is ignorant, let him continue to be ignorant. If you don't agree with what is written here, then you go continue to be ignorant and think that you're spiritual. Thinking that you have the understanding of God. Keep being ignorant. So there's another thing. They're going to agree with Paul and what he's written and the commandments of God, the commandments of the Lord. People who are spiritual are going to agree with that. Galatians, turn over to Galatians 6:1. Galatians 6:1. So here we see if any man is overtaken in any trespass, you who are spiritual, restore such a one in a spirit of gentleness, considering yourself, lest you also be tempted. Bear one another's burdens, and so fulfill the law of Christ. So those who are spiritual, they're going to be able to restore others and, with their spirit of gentleness and the spirituality that they have that's been given to them by God, they're going to be able to restore other people. They're going to be able to do that because God has given them the Spirit. Okay? He's given them their oil. He's blessed them with the oil, which is the Holy Spirit, so they can restore other people. They can restore them to that life and peace. John, go over to John 3:34. Just a couple more here, and then we'll move on to talking about other stuff here. For he whom God has sent speaks the words of God, for God does not give the Spirit by measure. So we see Jesus had the Spirit, and he had the Spirit fully. He had the Spirit to the maximum, more, the Spirit, the most that you can have the Spirit. And we see that Jesus did have that more than other prophets and people of God. He was given that measure, the unlimited Spirit. And, the other people of God, they're still given like a measure of God. They're given a measure of the Spirit of God, which they're still be able to do the same things that Jesus has done. Some of these people may be able to do, but Jesus had the Spirit more than anybody else has had the Spirit. So we're a part of that. And so people that are spiritual, they have a measure of the Spirit of God. And they have a measure of the Holy Spirit. And some may have it more than the others. So, and if we go to Acts 4:31, we see there that and when they had prayed, the place where they were assembled together was shaken, and they were filled with the Holy Spirit, and they spoke the word of God with boldness. So people who are filled with the Spirit have boldness in speaking and preaching the word of God and in teaching others and what they do. They have a boldness. So, okay, let's talk about the carnality. So if we go back to 1 Corinthians 3, we see here that, like I was saying, Paul was talking about how, I'm feeding you with milk, not with solid food, because they're carnal. And some of the things that he's saying, that these people that he was teaching and these brothers that he was teaching, is that they have envy and strife, and they have divisions. And what they were doing was they were saying that, hey, I'm of Paul, and another one saying I'm of Apollos, and they're propping up these teachers on a pedestal and placing them too high on a pedestal, and they can't receive anything for themselves. They can't receive the things of the Spirit for themselves because they're too carnal, and they're putting these people on a pedestal. So that's why he's saying it's like, it's only like you can receive milk. He's like, because I could go into other things, but you're not going to be able to receive that because you're still being carnal. You're still trying to, be in pride and, prop these people up. Instead of being, selfless, you're being in the self, and, you're trying to compete and you're trying to win and do all these things that are of carnality, of the flesh. So that's one work of the flesh. Of carnality is pride. And pride leads to envy, it leads to strife, it leads to these divisions, these people competing. And it's the same thing if you go back, John the Baptist with Jesus. The disciples that followed John the Baptist around, that when Jesus came and John continued to tell him, he would say that, there has to be more of Christ and less of me. My ministry's over and now it's time for Christ. And he would tell the people that were following him this, but then they would continue to kind of be in strife and be like, look, they're baptizing more than you. And, look, how come, you're not doing more things than he's doing? So they were kind of in this competitive mode. They were still in a competitive mode where they wanted to compete and, it's like they wanted to like win because they were in carnality. They were in confusion because the natural man doesn't receive the things of the Spirit of God for their foolishness to him. So when you're in that mind of carnality, the real things of God, they're going to seem foolish to you, and you're not going to be able to discern them. So that's something that happens in false spirituality as well. You see a lot of these people that are in the New Age and Hinduism and get involved in these different things that, they're in a lot of pride, and they'll flat out say, well, the things of the Bible, we don't really believe in those things, but we've got more our knowledge over here. And if you just follow me for the rest of your life and you sit here, I'll lead you to God. But they're just teaching a bunch of knowledge. They're teaching a bunch of pride. And usually they're all still involved in the lust of the flesh. And, there's people in Christian churches and things that can be lying and doing the same things, but it always comes out that, they're in some affair with somebody, in some adulterous thing, or looking at pornography, or they've been doing drugs and doing these things, and had been lying and they've been living in carnality. But that's what all of these people in these other religions, this fake spirituality, that's what happens when you're in carnality. Unfortunately, you're going to be led into fake spirituality. But, and even these, we see here, these people that were even listening to Paul, they were still, in a sense, even though they had a teacher like Paul that was giving them the truth, they still couldn't come to the truth because they could only receive milk because they were still too filled with their self. They were too selfish and they were still filled with this envy, this strife. They couldn't overcome this self. Because they were still in pride and they were trying to do it out of their own power instead of trust in God. And, I think Proverbs is a very good verse for overcoming the self. He says in Proverbs chapter 3, says here, trust in the Lord with all of your heart and lean not on your own understanding. So, to lean not on your own understanding means that a lot of the things that are going to cross your mind and that you're going to think or that you might say, you're going to say, man, maybe I don't really know. Maybe I don't really understand. God, why don't you show me? So how much are we really doing that? Because if you're leaning not to your own understanding, then that's what you're going to be doing. You're not just going to always be speaking whatever comes to your mind. You're going to try to examine those things and make sure that, they're coming from God. In all your ways, acknowledge him, and he shall direct your paths. Do not be wise in your own eyes. So you can't be wise in your own eyes and be spiritual. If you're wise in your own eyes, then you're going to be carnal. And you're going to consider the things of God. When somebody does really tell you the truth of God and the things of God, you're going to consider them foolishness because you're wise in your own eyes. You're puffed up with your own knowledge. You're in pride. Fear the Lord and depart from evil. It's going to be health to your flesh and strength to your bones. So pride is something of carnality. Now, if we go to Galatians real quick, Galatians 6. Let's see here. Yeah, Galatians 5, actually. Galatians 5 and 16, he says, walk in the Spirit, and you shall not fulfill the lust of the flesh. Okay? And then he says, now, the works of the flesh are evident. They're adultery, fornication, uncleanness, and lewdness. So, lust of the flesh and fornication, that is a part of carnality. And fornication is when you're having sex out of marriage. If you're looking at pornography, masturbating, doing any of these things, you're committing fornication and you're in carnality. So you're not going to be able to receive the things of the Spirit and you're going to be deceived. These are the things, the kind of sins that people are involved in, or the kind of carnal things that people are involved in that end up getting them deceived, that end up leading them into carnality and fake spirituality. These are the kind of carnal things that lead people into fake spirituality. Let me say it like that, okay? So you'll see that people that are into fake spirituality, they're participating in these things. Because they end up having a deceived mind. They're not able to comprehend the things of the spirit and be like, no, this person's a liar. They're not telling the truth. Because they can't discern the things of God because their mind is filled with death. So fornication, lust of the flesh, that is part of carnality. And another thing that's a part of carnality that I see is pretty big is people who are emotional. They get into emotional and they think that spirituality is about being emotional and, always like crying and, oh, that person, did you see the way that they said that prayer? It was like so effeminate and like, oh, praise God in the name of Jesus. I just pray right now and, saying it real flowery and effeminate. And there's a lot of people that think if you're emotional and you act like that, that equates to you being more spiritual, and it doesn't. A lot of women, a lot of wives think that they're more spiritual than their husband because they're more emotional, and they think, oh, well, my husband is not as emotional, therefore I'm more spiritual than he is. But that's not true. So being emotional has nothing to do with spirituality. We just went through and I showed you all the things of what spiritual being spiritual is, and none of those things say anything about being emotional. So that doesn't, running around and jumping around, and sometimes we might, feel those things and do those things, but that doesn't mean that you're more spiritual because you're doing those things. As we looked here, what makes you more spiritual is being filled with life and peace. Ministering your material things to other people, believing the things that the Bible says and that Paul and Jesus has written, going and restoring others, that's being spiritual. Being filled with the Spirit, that's being spiritual. Being bold, those are all aspects to being spiritual. And just because you have a lot of emotion, I can tell you, if you have a lot of emotion, that means that you're more carnal and that you have more carnality, because emotion is tied to the flesh, and people who are like that are going to be led around and be deceived by a lot of other people because they can be controlled by their emotions. People can pull on their strings and make them, very gullible people because they're emotional, and they'll believe other people because of certain ways that they act and certain, ways that they act effeminate and do different things. You see, and that's a lot of how women act, and emotional and all effeminate like that. And you can be deceived by people who are acting that way because it might seem like they like have more love and like they're loving you more, but that's not always the truth. Usually, people who have a lot of love for you will tell you the truth no matter what. Okay? They're not just always going to be accepting of everything that you do and, oh, oh, I love you. See, that's how mothers can actually sometimes w ruin you. My mother was like that. She was much too emotional and effeminate and, didn't stand up. She didn't have, the, like a man would stand up and tell you when you're wrong and say no. She was just always letting us do whatever we wanted to do, and actually that was ruining us because there were no boundaries, and that's not how life works. So God bless you, and I hope this helped you out. Okay? Be filled with the Spirit, and God bless.